And now, one source of electropollution has become an increasingly integral part of our lives. Up close and personal, the cell phone. In 1993, the first lawsuit was filed against the cell phone industry by a man who claimed his wife's brain tumor was caused by cell phone use, a brain tumor shaped exactly like her cell phone antenna. The resulting publicity prompted the cell phone industry to fund a $25 million study to prove that cell phones were safe. They hired Dr. George Carlo, a highly respected public health scientist, to conduct the research. Dr. Carlo's study was thorough and conclusive, proving just the opposite of what the cell phone companies wanted. In fact, Carlo found a strong connection between cell phone use and brain tumors, neurological disease, and genetic damage. The scientific evidence is mounting daily. Brain cancer is up 25% since cell phones became popular. Every year, there are 183,000 more cases in the U.S. alone. And this may just be the beginning. Like smoking and lead poisoning, the damage from electropollution is cumulative and may take years, even decades, to reveal itself. But every exposure may adversely affect your health. Several renowned neurosurgeons believe radiation from cell phones and other mobile devices are directly related to the 21% increase in brain tumors in children. Children and teenagers are at greatest risk from electropollution damage because their skulls are thinner, they have more brain fluid, and their bodies are not fully developed. How much time does your child spend on the cell phone every day? And how will the constant barrage of electromagnetic radiation from cell phone use affect your child's health in 5 years, 10 years, 20 or more years? And if you think using a hands-free set reduces your risk of exposure to deadly radiation, think again. According to research commissioned by Britain's Consumer Association, conventional hands-free sets may actually increase electric field strengths inside a user's head by 3.5 times. It appears that the headset wire acts as a concentrating aerial that attracts and channels radiation toward the head, not just from your cell phone, but from all sources of EMFs, electromagnetic radiation, and microwaves in the vicinity.
We're at Lake Berryessa. There's a dam here at Lake Berryessa.
Oh, I can see the hole now.
And there's a big hole.
This is like the bladder.
The bladder?
The bladder, and then it goes down.
Red fish? Where? Oh, I can't see it. No!
In May 2007, this strange creature was found on a farm in Mexico. The farmer drowned it out of fear. Since the end of 2008, researchers have been carrying out tests on the corpse, but the mystery is deepening. Even serious scientists are wondering if this creature comes from another planet. The tests showed that the being is not known to exist on Earth. Its body has characteristics of both lizards and humans. It also has a large brain, a sign that it was probably highly intelligent. There are frequent UFO sightings and reports of crop circles in the area, leading to the suspicion that the being was left behind by aliens. Farmers also reported seeing a second creature flee the scene.
Are you really going to die?
Who told you that?
Almost all their emotions with fear, and everyone has dreams but only a few realize them. Makes cowards for the rest of us.
I wasn't myself last night. Or maybe I really was.
You never gave us away.
Еще постою на краю.